Kara on.
Thank you.
I have some suggestions you might find compelling. Do you need recommendations, driver? Let me help you set a waypoint. Last event of the first Liberty Pillar. We're going to see how these souped-up works customs manage through winding mountain passes. Switching rides this time. We've got a modded Nissan GTR for you. Ready to go? Yep, we're going full Japan on this next event. I'll let Tochi take over now. He's not the chatty type, but when it comes to customs, you know, passion awakes.
This looks like we've got a Color Me Run kind of vibe going on here. Back to basics for the last works race. A Nissan GTR with an insane body kit. Japanese clans loved to make noise and showcase their styles in illegal races. Those cars, it was crazy. Kato knows his classics. Careful. Now Boss Osuzoku is mostly about oversized body kits. It's meant to be impressive. GTRs are a classic of the Japanese car culture. Aggressive by design, but as soon as they pass through Kato's hands, they become insane bangers. Come on now, finish that race.
What a win! The first of many, I am sure. Cars are an adventure, and they're for everyone. That's written in the Liberty Walk DNA. So much so that one of their three pillars is entirely focused on this credo. Mini Coopers. Every single car can become a unique supercar. Your first car, the Chrysler 300 SRT8. Boom!
You. Not the kind of car you expect to see at custom shows, huh? Trust me, I know my business. All tuning masterpieces. That's what Liberty Walk call a nation. Doesn't matter if it's a supercar or a sedan, these guys can dress anything up. You can do better than this. Bodies have been dropped for slightly smaller ones, but I still can't see the gap between the side skirts and the ground. Let's hope there are no speed bumps in this race. SRT8 is meaner than the regular 300. With a V8 Hemi under the hood, you're more than a basic luxury sedan. That's it. See you on the finish line. Stay focused. Let's move on.